At the heart of Punjab and Haryana states lies Chandigarh. And at the heart of Chandigarh lies the Punjab University, aka PU. PU traces its origin to the University of the Punjab, established by the British in 1882 in Lahore, in what was then undivided India. After the independence and subsequent partition of India in 1947, the university was split into two, one part for Pakistani Punjab, spelt with a U, and the other for Indian Punjab, spelt with an A. From 1947 till 1956, PU did not have a campus and functioned from several places such as Solan, Hoshiarpur, Amritsar and Delhi. However, with the plan to build independent India's first planned city, Chandigarh, the fortunes of PU also changed. Chandigarh was planned by the Swiss-born French architect Le Corbusier. And within the overall plan for Chandigarh, the PU campus was designed and its construction overseen primarily by Corbusier's cousin, Pierre Jeanneret. Work on the PU campus began at its present location in Sector 14 of Chandigarh in 1956. And today, this 550-acre residential campus houses 78 teaching and research departments and has 188 affiliated colleges. The university campus has three gates. Gate 1 is opposite the PGI, Gate 2 is opposite Sector 15, next to the university market, and Gate 3 is opposite the PU South campus in Sector 25. Once inside this clean and green place, one can either choose to walk or ride for a nominal charge in a non-polluting e-rickshaw. The Gandhi Bhavan is the prime attraction in the PU campus. Designed by Pierre, this building is dedicated to the words and works of Mahatma Gandhi. Behind the Gandhi Bhavan is the Fine Arts Museum. It is open for students and general public on weekdays and houses a collection of paintings and artifacts created by several artists. Behind the Fine Arts Museum is the University's Archaeology Museum, which houses artifacts and specimens which trace the evolution of human civilization and society in these parts. A short walk away is the Rose Garden, which is planted with numerous varieties of roses and offers manicured lawns and a walking track for visitors. And finally, there is the iconic and very famous Student Center, the nerve center of all academic as well as non-academic activities. And food is an important and integral part of university's culture. And the Student Center offers a variety of foods to suit all palates and pockets. And the charming coffee house at the top floor of the circular building offers South Indian food and a cozy environment. In all of Corbusier's plans, the cafeteria was always placed on the top floor of buildings. If you have liked this video and would like to see more such videos, please subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon for regular updates.